Welcome back to Captain's Draft 3.0, presented by Dota Cinema and Moonduck TV. My name is Sunsan, joined by Purge and Pimp Munkle on production slash observing. This is game 2 of a best of 3 series between Mama's Boys and Evil Geniuses. Evil Geniuses took game 1 pretty convincingly. Of course, they are in group po. Very important to note, Purge, are we going to see a Ricky this game?
I think it's possible, maybe.
Oh.
Who's the one team that was talking about Ricky? I think it was Crit, said he really wants to be in captain's mode. Unfortunately, he's not in this tournament, so we won't be seeing them pick it. He was also on top 10 of the Dota buff for Ricky, I noticed. So it seems like Crit's been playing a lot of Ricky.
So,
but he's
support Ricky?
That's the issue, though. I don't think that support Ricky. Like, if you're going to roam with Ricky, you should be playing Bounty Hunter, basically. So I just don't see Ricky being a pick for Crit unless he's playing offlane or something. Maybe dual offlane is a way to make it work. But
you were casting the only Ricky game. Who played it? I don't remember.
It was
Complexity?
Yeah, it was Complexity, and it was
Z-Freak.
It worked out pretty well. They basically played him as like a core role. Their lane setup was really weird. It wasn't like a support, it was like a core Ricky, and I think the hero's okay, but there's generally just a lot of other better heroes.
All right.
It's not as bad as I thought he was, but he's a little bad, I would say. Just a little.
Alright, my wish list for this game, I'm gonna stick with the Terror Blade. Also Ricky. Okay. And number 3, I'm gonna go with
Team pick. Well, it's definitely not going to be a Terror Blade on Mama's Boys now, that's for sure.
I'll say Wraith King. All right, go ahead. Your 3. That you want to see.
I think Wraith King. Oh, that I want to see. Chaos Knight, even though it's not going to happen. Ricky, even though it's not going to happen. Pugna, possible.
All right.
Those are my 3.
Nah, Pugna's good. Yeah, I like Pugna. I can.
No, I've actually been enjoying Pugna and pubs a lot lately. You just go Ags Aetherlands and you're really strong. Like, and then you get Veil afterwards or maybe another item. And then all of a sudden your life drain is just overpowered.
Is this a core Pugna or?
Yeah, you have to play core Pugna, I think. I guess you could do a support, but and I think the best build is actually 4-4-1. Because then your decrep lasts for 3.5 seconds and the cooldown 6. So if there's ever like a melee carry, like Wraith King, you just like permanently decrep him more or less and then do tons of damage. It's really good.
All right, well, Mama's Boys are going to start off with Silencer, get the Shadow Shaman, got some push action already going. EG, of course, with the Queen of Pain, that's going to be Sumail.
There's only 2 interiors left, what do they do?
Got to get that Pugna, son. Oh, it could be, okay, sounds a little crazy. They could go carry Queen of Pain, or even offlane Queen of Pain, and then Sumail, Storm Spirit. That's what I want to see. I changed all
against
my answers.
Against a Silencer and a Shadow Shaman? Are you stupid?
No, dude. BKB, Manta, you're good to go.
Oh wow, you're so right. Why don't you throw an Octarine to lower the cooldown of BKB and Mantle Warrior?
Dude, that would really be great.
Good. What a great build.
I'm not, okay, when I say stuff like that, I'm not saying it's good. It's what I want to see. That's the whole point of Captain's Draft, what you want to see. I also want to see Centaur, but he's not in this game. Okay,
I would like to see every hero rushing to Rapier and just see what happens. That would actually be funny. That would be an interesting game of Dota.
Remember the Klinx days where you somebody farms it up for you and just put it on Klinx?
I didn't play then, sorry.
Oh really? You used to be able to just pass items over, no problem. Those were the days when Dota was really imbalanced.
Sand King Murana, good picks here. Great setup. They can do a dual lane setup with that. They can do a roaming Murana. They can do a core Murana. I think she's not the best core, but she's okay at it. There's definitely better heroes for it. But I like Sand King. I think he's in a pretty good place. He has pretty dynamic items that you can buy. He's really good for setting up kills, obviously.
Perch. You know who's really good for Mama's Boys? Stands ready. Legion Commander! Although they haven't picked it yet. It's Pugna. Turn to pick. Not even kidding. Pugna is amazing against Sand King, good against
really
Queen
good
of Pain.
Sand King.
Like Sand King, it destroys. He cannot do Epicenter Blink combo at all. He has the Nether Ward down.
Unless he gets an Eggs or an Aetherlands, then he can. Kind of.
Well, I mean, at that point, like, it's
actually,
GG,
that's
right?
That's actually a counter to the Nether Ward build, actually. Because then your Burrow Strike range, so far, it doesn't matter that your Blink range is.
Yeah, that's true.
Or Blink gets kind. Morphling's a pick though, but interesting. Very burst heavy on EG, and they're one of the few teams that does run Axe occasionally. And I remember a game where they ran it and they played it really well. Universe plays a great Axe, and late game it just fell off, and it was like, damn, Axe is awful, super super late game. But he played so well leading up to that point that I was like, man, they did everything they could with this hero, and they just couldn't make it work. So maybe it'll work like that. I believe Battlecry does go through duel. I might be wrong on that, but I feel like it happened to me in a pub the other day, and I saved Denali because of it. Pretty good against Sven, hypothetically. If he's only dealing damage directly to you, that plus armor that you get from Battlecry can work. So So I feel like Axe is kind of okay this game. But and they also have a lot of general nukes and stuns, which are also good against melee heroes. If you can kite them, you're in a good spot. And they have a lot of heroes that are kind of hard to lock down on EG. So if they can just spread out a little bit and throw the nukes on Sven, they might win fights.
All right, and Mama's Boys with the last pick. What could it possibly be? Sven in all likelihood, core, or Legion Commander as well. Probably the other two support. So what is their last core? Some sort of a mid. What do you think of Klinks? Like, I don't like Orchid anymore, but it's actually really good against Morphling, especially this, obviously, this game.
It's pretty good against Morphling, but I feel like EG can punish him so easy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the Dusto build is by far more common, but there's definitely a lot of heroes on EG that would get punished by an Orchid.
Oh, right, yeah!
Pugna.
Yes!
I think Pugna is just absolutely, like you said, it's very good against Sand King, it's good against Quap. Pretty darn good against Morphling too. If he's Morphing, he's going to take a lot of damage from that. In some ways, it'll counteract the HP that he gains.
How much damage does he take from that? What the mana cost of Morph is like 25?
Remember the mana per second that it shifts. We'll take a look when we get...
You guys will see it. It's zaps him like every quarter of a second. It's pretty hilarious to watch.
It's a lot more smooth in its rotation, but I think Pugna is a pretty good pick here. It's going to be a support Pugna. He'll probably max out Blast and Nether Ward. I remember Cloud9 used to play support Pugna a little bit. They played with it around TI5, maybe TI4, and it seemed okay. It wasn't amazing. It was sometimes kind of good. I wouldn't say it's good this game, though. There's so much magic damage coming in from EG that the decrypt for allies isn't going to be amazing. It might help them chase down their opponents a bit more, but it also doesn't synergize very well with Legion Commander.
Well, that's the kind Nether of the... good. I feel like LC is the kind of the... I don't know. Looks the weirdest in this lineup right now. It's kind of the sore thumb sticking out.
Yeah. I mean, you don't have to use decrypt to amp your damage. You can still use Nether Ward, and you can still life drain enemies and allies.
I mean, it's not just for that, though. It's like they have this pseudo-push lineup, and then they have Legion Commander, who's like not a... I mean, you can push lanes, I guess, with overwhelming odds.
I just kind of like it. It's good at ganking a lot of the evasive heroes that EG has. Oh, they double sentry bottom. Big mistake from Soxer here.
He
probably tried to sentry, double tap it, and place the Observer Ward, and he misclicked. So lost both sense.
So it will be a mid-silencer, Weeha, the 8.3k MMR.
They will find Artz. Oh, he doesn't have waveform, he's in trouble.
Oh, Artz is going to morph to strength.
And they're going to see morph, now they know he doesn't have waveform.
How much damage can they actually do? Pycat's not close enough for a Stormhammer, but will it matter? Yapzor, well, Shackle in one second. Yeah, he's dead. He's done for.
Artz was not watching the map. That's the only way.
He was too busy looking at his profile, like, oh, the 8k MMR is so sweet.
I was either reading Twitch chat or alt-tabbed or there's no way. I mean, it happens a lot, actually. Back when we were on Zephyr, the same thing would happen. People don't necessarily pay attention during the draft. They come into the game, they right-click on the lane, they finish whatever they're doing in a web browser, and they tab back in. Oh, there's a team. You know, that shit happens.
Yeah. Especially that's called undisciplined play.
People do not give a shit about winning this, so there's no way they're actually trying fully hard.
But for EG, that's definitely true. Oh, it's a very early smoke from
Artz, though. He's on the millionaire.
EG. So Fear has the Burrow Strike ready to go. PPD in all likelihood will go Sacred Arrow. And they're going to go for Weeha right off the bat. Oh, they could get the Courier too. Which one's more important? Fear. He's going to go
for the hit stun. Yeah. All right. No, I think that's fine.
Burrow Strike into Arrow. Right clicks. Oh my god, they're going to get both. Oh, huge blunder from Weeha. Uses the... Oh, he's going to live. I don't know. He still has to run back to base though.
He traded Courier for that, basically, because the Courier brought him the salve that kept him alive. I think that's why he brought the salve. It was a little greedy. I like Fear's play.
By the way,
I think Fear absolutely made the right play, going for the hit and then Burrow Strike, because that way any ranged attack is going to kill it.
Right.
So that was a nice play there. But that's you know, Mama's Boy actually has two kills here, but they got the Courier, and that's absolutely going to make up for all of it. That's 175 gold to every hero.
Kind of understated. When you force somebody back to Fountain, he has to walk back. That's might be better in some cases than dying. Honestly,
Queen of
especially
Pain's
considering it's
three.
Not first blood, because they are Mama's Boys already had first blood.
Yeah, really good point. Queen of Pain's almost level 3. Weeha's just level 1. Now she can trade more effectively, and he's not gonna have a courier, so no bottle later. Like, this is a big advantage going to EG. That courier sniper absolutely made the whole thing worth it.
How does Axe match up against Legion Commander? This is a very interesting matchup.
Well, I think it's pretty good for Axe because he doesn't necessarily have to hit the Legion Commander. He can just like right click her to aggro creeps and stand next to her. I feel like it's way scarier for Legion. Her armor's quite low.
Oh, mid lane, we have another gank attempt onto Weeha. 8.3k will not get you out of this one, good sir. Sumail taking quite a bit of damage, but will loop through the day. AP support. Who is that? That is the Shadow Shaman. All right, just leeching some XP, I suppose.
It's a little interesting that they're pressuring mid so hard. I mean, they could gank top as well on the Legion Commander, but I guess Silencer's just so easy to gank, right? Like, if you Burrow Strike him and air him, he's already pretty much half dead just because you're going to get right clicks during that.
Yeah, the one lane, the one lane they're not going to win is this bottom lane. Arteezy, level 2. Basically, it's almost like the off lane. Has zero creep kills, zero denies, and as I say that, gets his first one. That's 2 minutes and 20 seconds into the game. Not a good start for him.
Definitely sucks. Definitely criticize this because if your dual roaming supports, you're always going to get underleveled. Even if you do get a lot of pressure out of it, at some stage you have underleveled supports. And now they're going to get an underleveled carry and an underfarmed carry. So is this really going to be worth it for EG to play the game like this?
Oh, yeah, so with an invis rune, he's just going to leech the XP. That's very nice. Very nice indeed. Arteezy forced back into the jungle. He's level 2.5 now. But Soxka, Soxka. How do you actually say that? It's just Soxka? I don't think that's the right way to pronounce it.
What? Look at the letters.
No, no, I know what the letters show. I don't think that's the right way to pronounce it, though.
I don't even know what country this guy's from. How am I supposed to know how to pronounce it?
Silencer goes down yet again. Not a good start for Weeha at all. Fear. Sandstorm's up, and there's no vision. Counteract the Sandstorm. Soxka, right?
What? You're thinking a different player.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're right.
There's
Soxka, how do you spell it?
It was like sock and then like S-H-K-A or something. It was like Soxka or something. Oh, okay. I don't remember.
Well,
but that's a French
is, like,
play. This is a different guy.
No, the reason I get mixed up is because the names are so close, I just tongue twister, you know?
I guess. It's Soxka.
Oh, Arteezy initiate on yet again. Waveform's out. Still pretty healthy overall. PPD's just right-clicking. PPD's the same level as Arteezy. That is not a usual sight to see.
But he has been jungling a little bit. It makes a lot of sense. If you can one-shot a neutral with 100 mana, be straightforward there.
Weeha, in the meantime, he's a 0-1-2 build, so we're not going to be seeing Arcane Curse anytime soon, I don't think.
You don't do that in the mid lane, I think. It's just not worth it.
Oh, we saw that the first game, though, today, right?
That was the support sensor, wasn't it?
Was it a dual lane? Okay. TZ getting pressured so much in this lane. He has 5 creep kills at the 4.5 minute mark. But top lane is a real interesting story. Legion Commander, 22 creep kills to the 24 of Axe. Very even overall, although obviously with the counter helix, Axe is able to dish out a little bit more damage to Legion Commander at this point. But the question is, what does Legion Commander do? Because she doesn't have much gank potential without a Blink Dagger. While Axe could technically TP in with Battlehunger giving a little bit of extra attack speed.
What are you saying, that Leech is going to contribute more early or something?
No, that's always the issue with Leech trying to mid lane. In the meantime, Burrow Strike into a Shadow Strike. Again, Silencer dead. My god. They're just picking on poor Weeha.
It's the nice thing about how much pressure they put on. Now, at this stage, they can just use a single hero to get the gank off because they use two to give Sumail this massive advantage here. Mm-hmm. So now he just goes ganks mid, then he stacks, and he ganks mid, then he stacks. And now he's level 3, he can start jungling. So this is going to completely pay off here for EG.
And with that level 2 Sandstorm, cool looking good.
Let's be real. The Sanking set, dude.
I need to send him our Sanking for sure. No doubt about it. Universe is probably just going to cut these waves, looking to find the Legion Commander. He's going to have some support from Arteezy. Support Arteezy more, please. Oh boy, TP support coming in though. Yapzor has the Shackle available. It's off the Aethershock first. Berserker's Call being faked out. A little bit of damage.
The gank is here, watch out.
Is this actually real? Arteezy getting Shackle. Don't know if they'll be able to find a kill because Arteezy just has literally nothing right now.
I mean, he knows he's getting nothing from his lane. He's like completely gimped here. Like, Morphling is not the solo, like, farm hero.
You know what's funny is he could, transition to support Morphling and just get a ridiculous stun from Adaptive Strike against Soxka. Aye, aye, aye. This mid lane is a disaster for Mama's boys.
I don't really blame him though. Like, it's very hard to predict that level when smoke gank. It doesn't come very often. There's the dive. Weeha's
Weeha.
You gotta shrink
is the Burrow Strike in range? Indeed it is. into a sonic wave and arrow to finish him off. The fairy fire will not save you, and even the disjoint just to add insult to injury. So male, good to go. Bycat forced to TP to mid lane. He's gonna get nothing out of it. Well, he has
He's got a mango, I guess. You're just gonna have Sandstorm though. You can Sandstorm this so easy. It's just not worth it for Pycat to try. Can't stop these ganks. Like, they just don't have the heroes. If they had like a Dazzle or a Shadow Demon or something, they can maybe keep their mid hero alive, but we're playing Captain's Draft, baby.
Baby. I mean, the big silver lining here for Mama's Boys is that RTZ still has nothing level 4. I don't mean to laugh. It's just, it's not often you see RTZ struggle this much.
But again, it's the tactical decision for EG. Rather than do a tri-lane, you know, that's probably why they didn't bother covering him. They said, all right, if we do Morphling, Sand King.
PPD done for.
If they do Sand King, Morphling, Mirana, are they really going to outlane a Pogna, Sven, and Shadow Shaman? And the reality is they probably won't, actually. So rather than take a tri-lane where they might lose the tri-lane setup, they instead just pressure the hell out of mid and guaranteed Sumail is a really good time.
And Legion Commander gets that first duel off. That's 10 extra damage for him or her, depending on your perspective. I still consider him a mustached man on a horse, but that's just me. Universe going to be spotted by Pugna, but nothing will come of it. Pugna level 4 right now. At what level do you start to just try to push down towers? Level 4 Nether Blast? Or whenever you can.
That isn't really something we're going to see this game, because it's support, man. Like, he doesn't have that much to do, as far as I'm concerned. It's hard to get up levels for him. I just don't know if I like the support Pugna. I'm not a huge fan of this. It's just gonna start feeding later. Like the ganks and the chain stuns on EG are a little bit too high. I just don't think this is the pick this game. Like, Nether Ward's gonna be good and all, and he can kind of jungle here, but he's gonna run out of mana soon, and then he's not gonna get it back unless he goes back to heal.
I mean, look at his inventory. That is the saddest sight that has ever been seen. His mid lane. Oh god, we have another gank attempt. Weeha gets off the ult, but RTZ is already morphed to strength, so he should be okay. Sumail, though, getting shackled up. Do they have enough damage to actually take him out before the blink? And that is a big fat no.
That was
global
really
silence. I mean, it prevented the death, so definitely needed.
I don't know if that mattered for death reasons, but it definitely let them get the setup on the Queen of Pain.
But back to Pugna, this one of the more level dependent heroes in the game for sure, and that's why I've never liked him as support personally. Just doesn't seem very effective overall.
He's very level dependent up until like level 10, I would say, and after that the extra levels aren't that big of a deal, but he definitely needs to hit 6. The 6 will help out a little bit in damage, but he's just not going to synergize this game. Like, I guess he can life drain whoever's getting dueled and stuff like that, or they can do a blast follow up on Stormhammer, but even that is going to be a bit iffy. I just don't see the Pugna being useful this game. I would love to get my mind changed though.
Alright, so I'm gonna be a stats man here for a second. When is the last time that you've seen PPD a higher level than RTZ? He's one level higher right now. He's basically transitioned to the one. He's gonna pop Moonlight Shadow. There's a TP coming in, but they're not gonna find anyone. At least not yet.
PPD wants the same skill build here on Mirana too. 1-2-2.
There must be a reason.
What the hell is this? The movement speed bonus from Leap.
Cooldown, only it, right? 4 seconds.
You don't grab this to like lower the mana by 5 and the cooldown by 4. It's gotta be that movement speed increase. The distance for some ledges, maybe possible, I guess. You might be able to leap from like one mid-river to the other mid-river, but
Fear sandstorming the creeps of Mama's Boys. They're gonna find him. Do they have vision? No, at least that I see. Pycat doesn't have anything, and sports do not either. Fear doesn't know this for sure though, so he's being passive.
Oh man, he's creating so much space. This is a Bamboo move right here. Tranquil boost makes a big difference. Can they get the... Yeah, I think this is doing
it. Oh, they're gonna get it. Damage. Indeed he does. And extra 2 intelligence. That's the first 2 for Weeha at the 10.5 minute mark. The funny thing is, even though he didn't know, he could have just stayed Sandstorm forever and would have been fine.
I sort of think that was worth it by Fear. He created a lot of space, made them run in circles. His Tranquil boots accomplished a lot. I really like Trank's song, Sand King. I think it's a great item. Lets you get away with not having blink for a long time. And they push bot tower, they push top tower, they farmed like 4 places in the meantime. I'm like absolutely sure they gained gold out of that.
Well, they are up 3.5k at this early stage of the game. Pycat right now very close to his blink dagger, and probably at that point they start turning on the aggression. In the meantime, Legion Commander about 800 or so away from hers, and don't think she's going to be pressured anytime soon. So you should be able to get that in good time. Universe, though, has his blink tag. Has he shown this off yet?
Probably. I mean, he's been hardcore farming top.
Not they're gonna smoke. Here we go. Yeah. Fear's getting close. Man, we're going to have quadruple blink dagger here pretty soon for each respective team. And there's the smoke. And off they go to the bottom lane. There's going to be some TPs. Time from Silencer. Has the global ult to work with. Universe. It's going to find Soxa. Oh, man. Into an arrow. Global Silencer is a little too late to save the Pugna. Poor little support guy. Does he even have boots yet? Oh, he does have boots, so that's something to be proud of, I suppose. Here comes the burst strike from Fear, PPD as well, but here comes Pycat. He's gonna get Sonic Wave down into the Queen of Pain. My god, the burst damage is out of control for Sumail. Three dead in the blink of an eye. Sumail's gonna get covered by the Moonlight Shadow of PPD. And they find more. Scream of Pain online, and yeah, down goes Weeha. This is a disaster for Mama's boys.
He's got his Yules ready too. Ooh. They don't have
fairy fire, and he's gonna go down. A little too cocky. Oh. More damage going the way of Legion Commander. They're turning this around. A little bit too cocky from EG. PPD with the leap available. We'll use it just in case. Universal TP out. A little bit of a blunder there from EG.
Yeah, that was very good for them though. The overall fight was awesome. I like the initiation. It's just a call and an arrow. And even if Global Silence comes out, you just have to cast those two abilities and you guarantee the kill on the hero. Because you're gonna get a 3 second stun into like a four, at least three, another 3 second stun. Really good gank there, and really good solution to Global Silence.
Does Universe go four staff next?
I think it's definitely possible, yeah.
Man. I just want like I wish we had like a side cam of just watching Arteezy this game. He is super poor. Has boots.
To make you feel better about him having like twice as much MMR as you when he's having a rough game.
Not really. It's funny because I hung out with him a lot at WCA. He's super nice. I like that guy a lot actually. But I don't feel good about that. I could care less. If this was back in my early 20s, Purge, then maybe I would care. I'd be a little bit more competitive. But I'm too old to care about that stuff anymore. Fear in the meantime. Yep. Do they have vision? They have sentries, but Fear's just gonna burrow strike Blink to safety.
Actually thought he might die there, but of course he has the Blink dagger, so doesn't have his ulti yet though.
Do you max press the attack or you leave it at
I max it before Moment of Courage for sure. Yeah.
Okay.
The only reason he got more Moment of Courage is because he was laning against in a 1v1 against a melee and he was trading hits there. Kinda made sense.
Arteezy's gonna bottle another rune here. And does he have anything on the courier? He's actually just that poor. Okay. But it doesn't really matter because everybody's creating so much space for themselves. I mean, Sumail's getting out of control, like you said, has the Yules. Fear with the Blink Dagger along with the Universe. And God knows what he gets. He's going Vanguard next, actually. What are your thoughts on that?
I think it's a good choice. He definitely needs more HP. There's a lot of nukes coming out of Mama's Boys. The overall damage is pretty right-click based, so having a Vanguard will be good. I think it's okay. Crimson Guard as a whole is very good against Mama's Boys. I don't know if he'll go all like into Crimson, by the way, but he definitely does have a lot of squishy heroes on his team, so buying an item that's going to give them that utility of keeping his team alive, I think is a really good idea.
Crimson Guard does not work against Serpent Wards, correct? The active ability, or does it?
Correct, it doesn't. It would counter it way too hard.
Yeah, okay. He has Moonlight Shadow available if they want to get a little bit aggressive here, but I think they need a third member. Is it going to counter ward this? Observer is getting close to expiring though. Weeha in the meantime. Ooh, look at the net worth. He is bottom four as the mid laner. That is not what you want to see.
Yeah, Silencer just doesn't farm that fast, really. He needs some hero kills and some advantage from ganks and stuff. Put initiate on this, they go for like an arrow combo, but.
Yeah, my initial reaction to the Pugna versus Sand King was being. I don't know. I'm pretty disappointed, to be honest. Because the first thing I see when I see a Sand King pick is, hey, Pugna is like the hard counter. But he's not going to get to that point.
Pugna, so.
Yeah, it's rough life, man.
Oh, he's actually maxing out Netherward equally with Netherblast.
But then again, like, it doesn't seem like a Weeha hero, right? Well, speaking of Pugna, the Global Silence comes out. Do they find the kill anyway? He can decrepify himself, I should say. Moonlight Shadows popped in response. Arteezy walking down mid lane. Weeha could actually get this kill if Moonlight Shadow was not there. But, oh my god, Arteezy.
Oh, the sentry!
Oh, Arteezy. Morphing up to strength. Be okay.
Oh, he almost cast the last word.
I feel like half the game is Arteezy walking back and forth between the rooms.
I mean, it's one good way to accelerate. You use waveform, it pushes and kills creeps more rapidly, and then you fill up your mana with runes.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Serpent wards, first time we've seen those, gonna be placed at this tier 1 tower. Arrow will not find anyone, but it looks to be a trade. Tier 1 for tier 1, top and bottom lane. What is PyCat looking for? He has the blink, obviously. 1600 gold. Let's see, is BKB worth it? It's okay. Does he go for... I mean, Mask of Madness isn't really a thing anymore. Like, what is...
Yeah, definitely not.
I mean, S and Y is pretty common, I guess.
Yeah, you go S and Y over to get yourself attack speed and movement speed. Just a lot safer, especially with a lot of nukes in the game. Mask of Madness is only really useful if you have a BKB. So, and the problem with that build is that you just max out an item so fast. If you get Blink, and you get Mask of Madness, and you get BKB, that's 3 items. Plus you have Treads, that's 4. You're like already out of item slots, and you need all of those things. So, the Helm of the Dominator is a lot more common now. You just stack a lot with it and kill neutrals.
Arteezy has a max of 503 health right now. No, so one last word to come down to about 200.
Yeah, I think he did this because he gets more out of his bottle then.
Yeah, I mean, the bottle is super underwhelming when you have high stats. It was, like you were talking about last game, super nerfed in the last patch.
I wonder what minute it'll be when Arteezy contributes to this game, but it might be a long time.
Oh, he's contributing. Oh boy, Berserker's Call, Universe comes in. Arteezy, yeah, better be careful. He's gonna drop to the deck, and that's more damage going the way of Legion Commander. But here comes Fear with the Epicenter Blink combination into a Burrow Shock, but a nice ult from PyCat. They're gonna clean up Fear in all likelihood. More damage going the way of Weeha in the form of Intelligence. And for one, they lose Legion Commander.
Arteezy contributed his opponent's gold gain.
Yeah. Well, in a way, he's contributing this whole game by the fact that they're targeting him so much, right?
Yeah, true.
And everybody else is creating space for his team. In a way, he is the support Morphling. Weeha initiated on yet again. Tonic Wave, not really going to do too much, okay, as Pugna just sucks him dry. Nicely done.
It's really the other way, blowing him.
Oh, okay. Thanks, Purge. Sex. Well, they're going to find the Shadow Shaman. PyCat almost got the kill on Sumail, but now they're just going to kite him.
Oh,
big time. Wave Ball comes in. Arteezy trying to right click. And PyCat with... Oh, okay. Random stun, but not going to do enough. And this tier 1's dead. Legion Commander, yeah. Gonna say.
It's a funny game, man. There's a lot of kills like that, basically. Like, PBD is like, oh, wow, Silencer came forward. I'm just gonna leap and hit him. And then the Legion Commander gets an easy new kill.
Level 4 overwhelming odds is nothing to scoff at. It's quite powerful with all those units.
PBD got a lot from that, though. He's almost got a Yule Scepter. Gonna allow him to do Yules into arrow kills. He can Yules whoever's dueling his allies. If Sven goes in for an initiation, he can basically defend himself depending on regardless of global silence being out. That's a really big thing to have for a support.
And we're seeing signs of life from Arteezy. He is middle of the pack and as far as net worth is concerned, which is honestly just a miracle how this game has gone. Has the Perseverance. He's on his way back, Purge. AKMMR. Looking to prevail versus the 8.3 and what did you say Soxa was? 8.2? Something like that?
Got it. Was
pretty damn high. Oh, we have the Yules by Sumail. And speaking of Stashka, just drops to the deck.
Yeah. Life Drain could only do so much.
Soxa. Kakshka. Toxka. Shushka. I mean, last Captain's Draft, I called DTL Raw Dirty Raw the whole time, so gonna be the first or last time, guys. PyCat. Only a double stack here. Don't think he wants to ult for this. No way. And Morphling on his way to Lincoln's. I think he wants to stack a little bit more.
I guess Machine doesn't farm that much since he got his helm, I guess. Probably busy fighting or something. And there's the Crimson Guard, so now the survivability of EGs can be pretty high. And also, you damage block cleave, by the way. It's another really cool thing. One of the few ways to reduce cleave damage is damage block. So if he uses the Crimson Guard and Sven rolls up and does like 200 damage cleave, you can block 50 of that with the Crimson Guard. It's actually kind of a cool Sven counter, at least in the mid game. Once you start critting for 300, who cares if you block 50?
Indeed. Well, mass TP's out there for Mama's Boys. Did not want to stick around in the EG jungle. If he's showing off his Yules, and we'll just TP out to safety.
Oh, and he broke smoke. That was...
Does he know he
broke smoke? The OP play. I don't think he did.
Well, Shadow Shaman's still there, he's good.
Unless this Observer Ward spotted him. This Observer Ward might have spotted the smoke, but...
Can you, For Morphling, can you morph when you're sheeped? Can you start casting it if you're sheeped? So the Blink Dagger is going to be pretty huge on Shadow Shaman. That's the one way they can... I mean, not that they have to worry about Morphling yet, but at a certain point,
only silences prevent it, though. Sheep covers his silence, basically. I think stuns you can still morph.
Yeah, stuns you can morph. Bottom tower has fallen. Well, bottom tower taken out with ease. No contestion there from Mama's Boys. And Arteezy about to get his ultimate orb, so getting very close to Lincoln Sphere now. That'll be super nice. Cannot get dueled unless something takes it off. Although, I mean, Shadow Shaman, that's kind of what he's built for, to use up Lincoln Spheres.
Yeah, that's true. He doesn't quite have Blink yet, but once he gets it, he can definitely deal with the Morphling.
Nether Ward is on the ground. And
an Arcane Rune on, so if they fight, they'd have a lower global cooldown. That'd be nice.
Oh, Universe jumps in on poor Pugna. Owie, owie. That is just disgusting. Oh, it's Sumail taking some big right clicks. Yules is popped. Sumail will fall regardless. Global Silence is activated as well. PPD, again, counteracts that Moonlight Shadow. Meanwhile, mid lane, Arteezy was initiated on, but Huiha was really the bait.
A little fight there. Big double kill for EG. They did lose Queen of Pain, but got another kill in the mid lane. That's pretty good. High catch chasing.
He wants it. They get he FP wants it this. Real good.
Pretty good FP. Pretty high HP. It'd be a little hard to burst down.
And Fear is going towards the Aghanim Scepter, which is redonkulous, if I do say so myself.
I think it's a really good choice from a support aspect. Just really long burrow strike range. It's really nice.
Alright, Pycat. I feel like his money is missing, actually. His secret shop, Fear. They have no vision for him. He's doing perfectly fine. Waveform in. Yapzor taking quite a bit of damage. Arteezy, though, taking damage in turn. He's morphing up, though. He's going to live through this, it looks like. He replicates out. They do find Axe, though. So in the end, one for one. It's Fear attempting to run away. Blink Dagger continually getting canceled. Burrow Strike is not there in time.
Okay.
So two for one. Mama's Boy's showing signs of life.
Went quite well. The Nether Ward did a lot there. It was a little bit of a bad call for Fear to go in. He did catch two heroes together, but the Axe follow-up just wasn't there. He was a little too far away. So, if he would have gotten the follow-up, it would have been a great fight for EG, but it wasn't. So, a bit of a bad call for Fear to start the fight like that, and it gives Mama's Boy some advantage.
Lincoln Sphere completed on Arteezy. Is this Tier 1 tower? Do they want to defend it? Arrow does connect on Weeha, but... the Nether Blast just gonna continually do damage to this Tier 1. And looking for the deny, gets an adaptive strike off, but no avail. Oh, Pycat jumps in, PPD is the target of choice. Global Silence activated. This could be a huge waste for Mama's Boys. They're actually retreating now.
Oh, Nether Ward died too, they can chase us.
Oh boy, PPD Yules into Arrow. Well, actually not connect, but Weeha's dead regardless.
Silence.
Alright, that's pretty good. Morphling now is very close to the top farmers on Mama's Boys.
Yeah, that's pretty
scary.
He's
back in the game.
But with Global Silence, I think they just push down mid, or at least take some towers.
Decent plan for...
Even Roche. Even Roche is available. Another ward being taken out. How much gold does that give? Like 80 gold? 100 gold? I think it's something like that.
I think like 80, yeah.
Pretty good. Pretty good. Yeah, this Tier 2 tower is going to be a target of choice for EG, and... don't think any defense will come.
They even got an illusion rune. It's really good for Morphling. His illusions are always very strong. It's the last hit as well, so 1400 gold for him now. I assume he'll go E-Blade next. It'll be really nice with us. Gets the Sven and Allegiant Commander. You can always just make somebody ethereal. Oh, and Universe is still inside.
Oh,
too.
Wow, yeah. That is not what Mama's Boys wants to have happen. Moonlight Gone. Shadow activated as well. Arteezy sticking around a little bit, but it doesn't really matter. He's going to get out just fine.
Oh, they're kind of chasing.
I mean, LC can't take off his Lincoln, so he needs assistance with that, unfortunately. But yeah, this is super impressive from Arteezy. He was getting, for lack of a better term, dumpstered early game, and now is, well...
we're taking rush, I think. Oh, maybe well. Arteezy.
Serpent Ward's placed.
Then you get rush.
This is a pretty risky play from Mama's Boys, but EG's not in a great position right
now.
Yeah,
I think they did it in a good way. They basically waited until EG went for Ancient Stacks and some survivability, and then they went straight for it right away. kind of a cool way to do
I got not even forced to ult for this.
But they very convenient. Like, surely they know they're in there, right? Yeah, they did, but I just think they chose the split push. They're not that worried about...
Legion Commander takes the Aegis. Interesting. I mean, she is the most farmed on Mama's Boys. Oh boy, Weeha. Bye-bye, good sir. Actually, now that I look at it, Ben is the most farmed. Arteez is going to wait for more. Universe looking for counter-initiation. Of course, has that Crimson Guard to work with. Very tanky. Meanwhile, in the jungle, PPD getting caught off guard. Shackled. I could actually ult for this. Find some more. Fear with a beautiful double Burrow Strike. Looking for Yapzor with the Orchid of Malevolence. He will pop one way or another. And down he goes. As more initiation possibilities here. Legion Commander looking for some mail. We'll get extra damage with the help of the Stormhammer. Up to 72 extra damage. Legion Commander is the saving grace here for Mama's Boys.
Playing great, 6-1-5 right now. He's having a really solid game. Getting a duel off on the co-op like that is going to change things big time. So, good little engagements for Mama's Boys. They lose two, but they get two.
Pycat has that 10-second BKB to work with. I thought that Shadow Shaman was going for a blink, but in fact it was an Aether Lens. So, going to have the extra range of Shackle and Sheep.
It's pretty nice, actually. The Shackle range ends up being like a typical ranged ability. The Hex range as well. It's
I assume the 8% extra damage does not apply to Serpent Wars, but I'm not sure.
I would
you know
assume
about that?
Not. But really, the bigger thing is just the cast range. The extra mana pool is also very good on this hero. The hero has a lot of mana, high mana abilities. He's definitely going to go Blink afterwards, I think. But just having the Aether Lens is pretty nice. He can actually cast Shackles from, say, farther away and not get caught. Things that are going to be really nice.
Arteez. He'll be good to go. His Lincoln's activated, but... I guess Pugna's decent at taking off Lincolns as well, especially if he had Ags, but I don't know if that's going to happen this game. Ags is insane for that.
Well, he's actually quite farmed now. He's got Arcanes and Mech on Pugna. This is pretty much the old school build. I think he should make an Aether Lens either way, but maybe he'll go Greaves to Aether Lens. I think that would be a pretty solid build. Maybe Greaves Ags. He's
my
shadow the range of life drain, basically.
I'm a little bit surprised that nobody went Greaves for EG because they can just take off Silence right away on themselves. Not looking for that as PPD wards up.
None of them are really mech heroes other than Mirana, and I really think that the Eulis build is a much better idea than the mech one.
Are you a believer in forcing mech if there's no mech hero? Just generally, I'm not talking about this game, but just generally speaking. You don't think mech is like super core?
Mech is really good. It all depends on what your team fight if you have a team fight lineup, if you're going to do 5-man, then yeah, a mech is pretty much needed, but playing a different style, then you don't have to have mech. And EG hasn't been playing a 5-man style.
Oh yeah, PPD.
See what that Yules did? Ooh. Mech wasn't going to save him there. I mean, he probably would have died if he had mech, but...
Oh, that's, yeah.
He still would have left away, right? But...
Oh, LC. In the vicinity of a PPD... PPD is just going to TP out in the trees. Teezy, I'm guessing this is... Well, it could be a Manta, but I was thinking Scotty, perhaps. What would your choice be for Artur?
It's probably going to be Scotty, I would guess, because of the Sven having BKB. If he gets a Scotty, they can basically permanently kite the Sven and keep him a bit more limited. If he goes to shotgun build, it doesn't do that much when their BKBs are up, so it'd be kind of weak right now if he got it. If he gets Scotty, though, he's just very strong and can slow his opponents and, as a whole, does more damage.
PPD looking to defend this tower with Fear, who now has Aghanim Scepter, by the way. Let's see how that comes to effect. Well, there you go. Comes out of nowhere. Still has the blink to get the hell out if he needs to. And this tier 2 tower taking quite a bit of damage with those supports. In the meantime, Artur pushing bot lane. So they would love to trade tier 3 for tier 2. First coming in though, Weeha with Global Silence available. Morphling has the Replicate. Oh, Lincoln's his pop. The Sables will follow. Weeha with the Silence. And down goes Morphling. My goodness, he dropped really fast. Universe, of course, the pop BKB will be out to safety. Sumail caught with the Stormhammer, and there is the duel. More damage for Legion Commander, plus 90.
Dude, what a good 20 seconds for Mama's Boys. That's like the two most farmed heroes on the enemy team. Super big kills. The Morphling one was pretty tough, but they were able to chain disable him there before his Lincolns went off. I think they used maybe Force Staff to break it initially, or they used... I don't think he did. I don't think Pud was there.
No, So my guess is he actually used Shackle because he didn't use it the whole time, I don't think. I saw the hex go off.
I thought it was Last Word, but I might be wrong. I think they did Last Word, and then they hexed him, and then started auto-attacking him when the hex was going away. The global sounds. Pretty sure is what happened. He used Last Word to break the Lincolns, then the hex came, and all that time, and then afterwards they global sounds, so Arteezy couldn't use more.
Okay.
He just died to Reckless.
Fear pushing top lane. And that's the beauty of having Aghanim Scepter. You have so many escape mechanisms now. You have Sandstorm, you have Burrow Strike, you have Blink. Yeah. Arteezy. Oh, he's gonna get ganked. Oh my god. Oh my goodness, they get it! Ooh, it was actually quite close, but... 4 damage. Legion Commander, looking good.
Hit him twice and it was so big. That attack speed's great. The Moon Shard really helping out. Sven Moon Shard's actually a great ability because, or a great item to have on the hero, over Daedalus in some cases. Catch anybody top, that'll explain it.
Yep, sir. No Blink Dagger, so it doesn't have much catch potential, unfortunately. Going for Aghanim Scepter next, it seems. Yules on the Shadow Shaman arrow. I don't think he's connected once on these.
It was on cooldown there, so he had the arrow late. It wasn't completely his fault. But the nice thing about the Moon Shard is that the problem with Sven is that your lockdown is a bit weak, only 2 seconds. So you basically have 2 seconds to hit somebody in a lot of cases. If you grab Moon Shard, you're increasing the amount of times you get to hit them. Whereas if you have a Daedalus, you kind of put everything in on critting, whether or not you crit. So I like the Moon Shard on Sven. I think it's a great item for damage in the mid game.
When you get Moon Shard, do you feel kind of sad when you have to eat it? Mid lane, Queen of Pain. Whoa, I feel like I'm saying this every time it's off cooldown, but more damage, the Wave of Legion Commander, plus 126.
Her damage is really good now. Just these two people have been ganking really well. Pikehat and Legion Commander together. Is Masakare. Sorry.
Masakare. Exactly. Anyway, how you say it?
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, anyway, back to my point, my very important point, Verge. Do you feel sad when you have to eat your Moon Shard? Because I do.
I very rarely will eat a Moon Shard.
Really?
I mean, I'll buy it like 7th item or whatever and eat it, but the few times I do buy it early, I usually don't eat it that early. The Absolute looks in trouble.
Yeah, he's dead. What do you mean by trouble? Absolutely. Universe. Is he going Ags? I guess so. I like Ags on Ags.
Oh, duh. He made Manta because of Silence Radius.
What's that?
He made Manta on Morphling because of Silence. Stupid.
How are we stupid?
Because that's the most obvious thing ever.
No.
Because he gets a freaking silencer.
Yeah, but I said it could be Manta or Scotty.
Well, alright, so I'm an idiot. I'll take this one. So obviously, it was going to be Manta. He needs a... The problem is that Manta is not amazing for impact. Like, obviously, having a Scotty is better in the moment, but sometimes you need Manta to remove silences, basically.
I think it probably threw us off because he went Ultimate Orb first, which is not as common, obviously.
Yeah, it's the Manta's also just not good against Sven, because he's going to kill the illusions really easily, so relying on it as a damage item is just not very strong in a game with this lot of AoE.
We have a smoke here by EG, placing an Observer Ward. Pika has 3,500 gold. Does he just go Satanic now? Does he go Daedalus?
Daedalus, definitely. You wouldn't
Daedalus
go Satanic.
Daedalus is dirty.
Satanic's okay because the strength that you have makes your ultimate do more damage. So with God's strength, the Satanic actually gives you like an extra 50 damage. So Satanic is like a 75 damage item, which is good. But if you get Daedalus and you crit, you just kind of win game. So I think Daedalus is the item for sure.
Oh, now we have a smoke by Mama's Boys. Gonna attempt to reclaim their jungle that EG has just decimated. They've just shat all over it. Probably the best way to put it. And it pops. They know they're here. He's gonna initiate onto whom? Arrow will not connect. Onto Legion Commander, who pops the BKB, looking for PPD. He is so fast, but somehow finds the range with Duel. And the Aether Shock will add more damage to Legion Commander's stats.
And they got the gem, so pretty big fight there for Mama's Voice. Not huge in terms of gold, but getting the gem alone is gonna do a lot.
Sometimes I don't understand range, Purge. I really don't. That was
kinda weird.
Highlight Duel right now on camera, please. That's what the range is supposed to be. The range was literally quadruple that.
Well, I think if you're casting the spell, then while the animation is going on, the person can run away.
Well, no,
I
understand how it works. I'm just saying it's weird to see something, especially with like some auto attacks from...
I've seen
some like 900 range auto attacks from melee heroes.
Those are usually bugs due to the slow interaction. Sometimes when they're slows, it lets you auto attack farther. But yeah, sometimes there's some weird. I've died a couple times auto attacks that were definitely outside of the range that I should have died.
Oh my god, Legion Commander, double damage. Oh, disgusting.
It's good. It only gives her 136 though.
I guess that's true. It's not, the extra damage is not considered base then, huh?
So you don't get extra damage from the duel with the double damage. It's still good. It's if you want to really craigasm about DDs, sorry about the memeing guys, don't mean to go there, but it's a Tiny and Morph are the two best.
Yeah,
DD
Tiny is
heroes.
Super sick. Well,
can't believe I said craigasm on stream. I'm really embarrassed right now.
You should be. I don't meme. I don't know about you, Purge. Oh, we've been saying thanks, Purge. That's technically a meme, right?
But that one's actually super relevant to me, so it's yeah. Kind of fair.
I agree. Okay, you get one pass. Everybody gets one meme pass. I have yet to use mine. Pycat, ooh, blinks out just in time. Did they see him? I'm not sure if they saw him. I guess not.
They see him for me, no.
Yeah, they just placed the Observer Ward and PPD will run away.
Looks like Ag's next up for Axe. Lower cooldown on Cooling Blade. Bigger threshold.
Oh wow. My god, Pycat Blink, what the hell just happened there? Universe is the target for Legion Commander. Don't think he has enough damage to get this. Indeed, he does, though, at the last moment in time. Arteezy already used Manta, so the silence will just decimate him. Oh, he has Waveform up now. I hear the Epicenter coming in. From Fear, it's completely whipped until the Burrow Strike finally connects on Legion Commander. And down she goes, but that is just the Aegis. Pycat doesn't look like he's going to get the kill onto Arteezy, who barely TPs out in time.
And Legion and the Sven, they just hit so hard, and that's two heroes, like, wailing on enemy heroes. Universe looks squishy in that fight. I almost think he needs to not go Eggs, and he needs to go, like, Shivas or something.
Yeah, Shivas would be really cool.
But they're just wrecking these team fights, and again, it's Global Silence, man. How do you take fights against Global?
Well, let's
basically
see.
Have to initiate and do their stuns first, or they have to kill stuns at the start.
Like, they have the Yules on Quap and Mirana, and then, of course, the Manta on Morphling.
We'll see if
Sumail
finds this gem. By the way, there's a gem over here on the ground.
Actually, literally every single one of the heroes on EG can take off Global Silence. But then you're self-Yulesing, and that's not always the perfect scenario.
And then you lose 2.5 seconds of potential initiation.
And this Rax is in peril. Fortifications pop. That might be fine for Mama's Boys. God Strength is up, though, so he's just going to use it. Arrow will connect! Onto Pycat, they better be careful as Pugna is going to be saving
him
with
duel
that
on
delicious sucking off. Purge just loves so much. Tier 3 tower's dead. Scotty picked up by Morphling. They're going to look to reinitiate. Pycat pops the BKB and just goes for that melee rack.
So fast.
No problem.
Plus the attack, so much attack speed for Sven here. And the duel was wasted on the Queen of Pain due to the new Lincolns, but it didn't matter. They still killed the barracks so easily.
Yeah, looking scary for EG. If you look at the net worth, it's just plummeted. Well, it's not even just a sudden plummet. This has been over the course of maybe 10, 15 minutes. Just a gradual lead being slipped away from EG. Mama's Boy's playing quite well. Of course, you can't underestimate a Morphling, as he scales ridiculously well.
He does, and he's only three expensive items in.
Yeah. And Sven, I mean, he's very strong, but potential to be kited is more than almost any other hero. Ursa's probably number one on the list. Pugna. They're going to use a Global Silence to try to save this cuddly little guy. Will it matter? Nope. Universe dunks him into oblivion. Pycat yules up. Oh, this could be huge for EG. Arrow will connect into the Burrow Strike, and Pycat, you are dead. He has buyback. Same with the Pugna. And EG's going to look, perhaps, to force them out.
Arteezy's definitely wants to go high ground, but they need creeps here. They've got a lot of push power as well, so it's looking pretty good for them.
The Fear, Blink Dagger is disabled. Arteezy has the Lincoln Sphere activated on himself. Unless it's
the
second one.
One.
Oh,
yeah.
It is. Okay.
He's hitting the tower. He should definitely have two Lincolns on him. I think that makes a lot of sense. Just a Pugna buyback, and they're going to retreat. They didn't get much advantage from that, but they got a little.
God. Oh my god, Fear.
Oh, he does get caught.
Oh,
my
Fear.
God, that cast range.
No. Oh, more damage. That was super, super risky and with very little gain. I'm surprised he even went for that, but almost too cocky from Fear.
It's hard to catch by all means, but they got him there. The duel was just enough. And so much damage on Legion, plus 180. That's like two damage items. It's incredible.
Yeah. What does he go for next? He has the Assault Curious. Obviously, he wants to save for buyback, but with like Heart, Satanic,
I would almost like Legion to buy. He could buy MKB or Daedalus. I would really like a Daedalus, actually, because he's hitting for like 200 or 370 damage or something. If he gets a Daedalus on top of that, and he's just right clicking here, he's just going to kill him. Like, just die. He could also buy something like a Desso since he has AC, I guess, but I think it's too late to buy a Desso. You might as well go for the big items.
Yeah, I don't like Desso. What do you think of Moonshard?
It's not a bad idea, because he does have so much damage from duel. I think that's a pretty good choice. But I don't know, he's already got such good attack speed when he presses the attack on himself.
So has he been pressing attacking himself, or has he been using it on...
When he's dueling, I'm sure he does sometimes, but when they're doing high ground siege, definitely on Sven.
I feel like that hero is just sometimes so awkward to initiate with, because you press the attack yourself, you gotta blink, you gotta pop a lame mill. Sometimes it's better to just save it. I mean, considering how much damage he has, he doesn't really have to press the attack on some of the targets, depending on who he goes
definitely.
For.
If it's like Morphling or maybe Axe, then yeah, but the rest of the heroes, no, he doesn't.
Sumail has plate mail, so in all likelihood going for Shiva's. Could be AC, actually. We've been seeing AC quite a bit on Quap, actually.
And they don't really have another AC carrier. Axe could perhaps build it, but I
He's
doubt
all in on this Axe, man. He wants it. He could finish it right now, but save him for buyback, I'm sure.
Yeah.
There's a big
Except
item.
On Sensor. Mm. That's really good. Very good against a lot of the EG heroes.
I feel like a Lotus Orb might be needed now for EG, but who picks it up? Morana's not going to be farm enough to get it.
I mean, just about any of them can.
Really. Oh, Sumail finds Pycat. Global Silence is used to try to save him. Another Yules to keep Pycat in place. Can't blink thanks to the damage. Pops the BKB. Will dodge the Burrow Strike as a result. Look at the damage he's doing. Sumail and Arteezy getting cleaved into oblivion, but they will live. Moonlight Shadows popped in defense. All in all, EG probably came out on top of that. You forced the BKB, forced the God Strength.
Yes, it was an 8-second. They almost died. That was pretty scary.
Yeah, that's true.
It seems like the Illusions went in first. I was just worried. Basher on who?
LC.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense, yeah. Then he can do Blink Abyssal. He doesn't have to necessarily duel somebody. That's a really good choice. Rather than going for a full carry build, utility is a bit better in this case. I like that choice. It's better than what I thought of.
Well, we'll be a Shiva's for Sumail. I kind of agree with your earlier sentiment with the fact that Universe could have gone Shiva's, and then in this case, Sumail could have gone AC. But now, it doesn't look like anybody's going to be able to afford AC this game. But Axe is officially finished on Universe, so we'll see how this works out for him.
Well, we can still talk about BOTs. Like, Axe can get a BOT next and then grab an AC. Something like that might be an option.
That's true. If the game goes long enough, which has definite potential to do so. The longer this game goes, the scarier Legion Commander gets, too. Along with Morphling. He's still, like you talked about earlier, only has 2.5 items right now. Well, 3.5, I guess. Here, Burrow Strikes. TP is not available for another couple seconds. He'll be okay. Unless some miracle Pycat finds him, but... Here's sticking around quite a while. Oh, my. Oh, my!
I'm wondering if he's going to Burrow Strike into Pycat accidentally.
You know, they're technically looking at each other. Okay. Dream cheaters. Jesus.
Wow, that was actually so close. They see him. They saw him. Pycat had vision of him.
Burrow Strike has infinite range. Let's see if he can do anything about it. Well, Sandstorm will dodge the Storm Hammer. Oh my god, they're going to find him. Fear pops the BKB. Has Blink available again until he gets right-clicked. Legion Commander looking for one more duel. He's greedy. He wants the damage. Fear just TP's out with the Burrow Strike TP again. My god.
He just created so much freaking space.
So ballsy.
That was really well done by him.
If any of you guys were wondering how big Fear's balls are, well, they're ginormous, let me tell you. There's a reason he's in Group Hippo, guys.
Pretty funny you say that, actually.
Why? Because of that photo of him? I didn't notice he had huge testicles, though. I'll have to reinvestigate. Sorry, guys. I don't remember.
That's my bad. I just couldn't handle the irony of you saying that casually and not realizing what you said. That's disrespectful to me. I wonder, huh?
What? How is it disrespectful?
Because I brought up a sore subject.
Is it a sore subject? I would
be a sore subject if that was me. Yeah,
really?
Definitely. Yeah, oh. Are you kidding?
Huh. That's actually shocking to hear.
What? Says the guy who shits himself and doesn't care to tell the internet. Yeah. Real shocking.
Hey, I would say that's a low blow, but I actually don't care, like you said. So
exactly. That's why you're not a proper.
Well, no,
proper
but it's completely different. It's not like that. I feel like that photo is not like a horrible thing, is it? I didn't think that at least. That was
really,
my impression.
God, what? You're so
I don't think
up,
he
dude.
Cares at all. But maybe I'll ask him.
I am sure he cares at least 1%. He's like, 1%? Yeah, I wish that wasn't public on the internet.
All right, while we talked about that, Silencer just got shit on. So. There's that. He doesn't have buyback. It's 70 seconds on the deck. Meanwhile, bottom jungle, radiant jungle, I should say, Fear again dies. More damage. You heard this story before. They got the TP back, the universe. Looking to initiate on this. TP is canceled. Pycat. All he can do is right click, pops the BKB. Arteezy taking quite a bit of damage. He's going to use the replica to get out. Universe in the meantime, Berserker's Call. He has Blink available. We'll TP out and should not make it. My goodness. Nice stun. Bottom lane in the meantime. Sumail shackled up. Yapzor taking the right clicks. The PPD. Something to fear indeed, but it's a 1-for-1 at the end of the day. Legion Commander.
Duel Syndrome.
Have duel for another 16 seconds. Tough to catch PPD, and we'll just give up. Arrow, not going to be there.
Bit of a weird fight. They got a gem out of it, but they lose Sumail on the Quap in exchange for support. So I think that's going to go to Mama's Boy for the edge there. They don't have any gems anymore, though, so that's kind of bad. But there's not a lot of wards on the map. There's been a lot of gems moving around, so...
Yeah, that was a 3,000 gold swing for Mama's Boys, actually.
Yeah, that's kind of dangerous.
EG did get a little bit of a lead back in the last few minutes, but that... Essentially, that fight there is back to even, technically speaking, as far as the net worth is concerned. The big question mark is, when is Roshan spawn? And he's up and running, and this is going to be a freebie. That's with cheese as well. Who picks it up, though? Sven can't really drop unless he wants to eat a moon shard. I don't know if that's worth it. Maybe it is.
I'm not sure.
Maybe you eat the moon shard here and pick the cheese and then Aegis on somebody else.
Yeah, I'm not sure I like that. I think they're waiting to kill it. Because they want the guy that's actually going to grab it. It's me, Weeha. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Badly.
He's got a wand and a TP scroll. Makes more sense for him to grab it.
Yeah, Weeha takes the Aegis. Sven took the cheese. He did eat the... I mean, I think that's fine, because Aegis is horrible on Sven, so cheese definitely makes sense on him, and that's the only way he could do that.
That's a good point. So Weeha grabs it. He'll be a little bit harder to kill. Arteezy has a butterfly now, so he's going the full... This is like the old-school Morphling build. All agility makes your illusions really strong. He's got a DD in it right now, also.
Do you still go ethereal after this? I mean, usually when we see the shotgun build, it's earlier, but is there still...
I feel like you have to. Like, why would you pass it up, you know? It's, like, so good. It's already an item that people sometimes get second, and you've got 260 agility. Like, you could actually just throw... You could do 1,000 damage. You could do, like, 1,200 damage. You could one-shot, like, just about any hero on Mama's Voice.
If that's the case, he should get the Ghost Scepter pretty soon once he has enough for buyback as well, because against Sven, against Legion Commander, I mean, that'd be quite helpful, I'm sure.
Depends on TPs. Might need the TPs.
Oh, that's true. I didn't realize he didn't have Boots of Travel yet. That's another thing to think about as well. I mean, I think the later this... It's actually really tough to call, but the later this game goes, Morphling becomes the hardest carry overall. But Legion Commander is super scary, obvious, for obvious reasons, along with Sven.
The only problem with Legion's build is that he has to rely on a Blink and a BKB, and that's two items that aren't very good for carry potential. Whereas Morphling just has like 6,000 gold items. So despite the net worth being vaguely close... I said it wrong there, I know. I felt that one coming. despite their net worth being somewhat close, Morphling's items are all extremely good carry items, whereas Legion has to rely on Blade Mail, Blink Dagger, BKB, all these items that don't help him in the late game.
We have a four-man smoke from Mama's Boys as the remaining member, which is Weeha's, dedicated to defend this bottom lane. And, oh man, they actually might find some mail, even though he's deep in the bowels of the trees here. Will the smoke get popped? Oh my god, it does.
It did. They
Legion Commander knows. Doesn't know exactly what direction. The blink available. Has to go through Lincoln's as well, mind you. Oh man, they are so close. One tree is literally in the way of finding this poor Sumail, who gets Moonlight Shadow now.
I don't even think he realizes that they're there. This is the crazy part.
Yeah. That was so close to disaster. Yeah. Man, oh man. Top lane, though.
What about
the push commences. Arteezy, Lincoln just pops. Immediately replicates up. Look at the damage from his illusions. Jesus, man.
It's okay. It's not amazing.
I hear the duel. It's on PPD. More damage. Yep. There you go. 216. Was that... You said gem? Okay, yeah.
Yeah, they got the gem out of that.
feel like this gem is just going back and forth, unless it's a small. Might be in somebody's stash, the second one. Unless that one's just really passing for.
Really good to pick it up this late, actually, because the movement speed advantage it gives you is huge. It's like 55 movement speed. People buy Yasha's just for movement speed in some cases. So upgrading your boots of travel is really, really good.
And he has enough for Ghost Scepter right now, too. And buyback. Mid lane in the meantime.
Oh, that's
Arteezy.
Nice.
Yeah, takes out the creep so nobody can TP to it. Just pounding into Yapzor. Getting another to mail. Sonic Wave on the Yapzor, and that is going to be a Shadow Shaman. Great
that was
place for
so
EG.
Well played. Like, kept canceling. Like, he could have killed that Shadow Shaman, just prioritized TPs entirely. That was so big. Really nicely done.
And Arteezy is the one they're going to be holding the gem. Is that the third gem now? Yeah, I think so. There's two for Mama's Boys. So yeah, what do you think of the Ghost Scepter? Should he get that first? I mean, I think he kind of has to, right?
No.
I mean, see that or Eagle Song.
He grabbed the Eagle Song.
Really?
Super awful.
I mean, it's
more damage, more attack speed.
Wait,
more...
you're saying Ghost Scepter super awful?
No, I don't know why we're having this discussion. Like, if he's gonna go E-Blade, he's gonna go E-Blade. He gets a helmet down and he's gonna go Satanic. I think this build is, this makes sense, I guess. He's already got tons of damage. If he buys the E-Blade, it does give him nuke potential, but he might as well have something that basically gives him a free Aegis, and he's gonna have that now. And he can morph even more into agility. He's currently sitting at about 32 strength for safety reasons. 2.5k HP is a ton. It'll help him out during the duels a little bit. So once he gets Satanic, he can put all the rest of his strength into agility.
Moonlight Shadow. Will EG find anyone? TZ will walk right into PyCat. Who they want to prioritize? Although Legion Commander is actually invisible thanks to a rune. PyCat taking a lot of damage to RTZ. Duel gonna be on Universe. Do they have enough damage to actually get him? Here comes the Epicenter combination from Fear. That is Aegis going down the tubes for Weeha. Global Silence is still up and running, but that is a dead Legion Commander, and I don't even know if it's worth using. He's gonna use it right now. PyCat on the run, has a blink available to get the hell out of dodge if he needs to. Buyback, was that? Who bought back? Legion Commander bought back. Can he even get here in time? Weeha pops the BKB, pops the cheese, looking for as much damage as possible. Arteezy is just destroying him. One more Adaptive Strike takes him out. PyCat in the meantime getting completely kited in this fight. He has done literally nothing overall. One waveform should be enough to take out PyCat as well. And this fight for EG has gone super well. Yapzor doing a 1v1 battle with PPD as more buybacks come into the fray. Sven, Legion Commander trying to use the Serpent Wards to cover, but Arteezy just does too much damage at this point of the game. That is a team wipe times a million, it feels like, with two buybacks. Yeah. Sven, ooh.
It's very clear that Morphling is one of the best late game carries, and this completely showed it, man. He just jumps in the fight, and his opponents can't really focus him. I followed him that whole fight, and he just did an insane amount of damage. Look at the fight recap. Did 6.8k damage in that fight, and that was basically just auto attacks.
That was so much DPS. 1,000 cold swing. Wow.
Yeah, he's here, ridiculous. Man. He's farmed. It's time to party. He still can get a moon shard, but he's got basically like six of some of the most expensive.
Can you say that again? I need to hear that again.
It's time to party.
Yeah. Just doesn't sound like a typical Purge quote. Is all. Somebody needs to tweet that. Sure Purge that. 2016. It's time to party, guys. And Morphling feels pretty damn safe overall. Legion Commander. They know he doesn't have buyback. Arteezy. Well, the counter initiation there from Universe. We do have a buyback this time by Pugna, but my god, Weeha gets destroyed. Universe takes a beating from PyCat, though. BKB popped by him, but again, the kiting is real. The double kill, literally two-shot Arteezy, getting too cocky.
That's so unfair.
He buys back. He's going to TP back into the fray. PyCat's ult's not going to last too much longer. And again, he can get kited. Orchid it up. And Arteezy just finishes off the Satanic. Has no buyback, of course, just used it. Dumail pretty low fear with a long-ass Burrow Strike thanks to the Aghanim Scepter. Yapzor getting healed by Soxa. Sonic Wave getting them both low. Yapzor might actually fall to the Shadow Strike and Caustic Finale combination, but nope. Looks to survive as Midrax getting pounded upon again. Arteezy, Fortification pop by Mama's Boys. Wanted to say Monkey Boys again. And this is going to be a free rack.
The only reason that Arteezy died there is because he made an illusion of the Sven. So Sven hit the illusion, the cleave does pure damage.
Really?
And then he double hit. Like, if he was hitting Morphling directly, it wouldn't have done 1400 damage a hit. But because he was hitting somebody else, the cleave damage did just about that much. It did like 800, 900 a cleave. It was
That's
amazing.
Pretty insane.
So it's kind of a mistake from Arteezy, but it was well played by PyCat to abuse that cleave.
Yeah, and even though they can probably finish this game, EG is probably going to play it quite safe. They need to wait for buyback and Morphling. They don't want to make any huge mistakes like that again. My water's right. And he has 2,700 gold. Of course, Flyback's not going to be available for another 6 minutes. In the meantime, he could probably farm with that Moonshard that you were talking about.
Yeah. Dude, Artesia has come so far this game, hasn't
yeah.
he?
Yeah. Seriously. Literally the worst start to one of the hardest Morphling carries we've seen in a while.
He was like roaming level 3 when everyone else in the game is like level 5. He's like, oh, I'm going to go gank, guys, you know? He just caught up. He farmed all game. He's got 585 CS. Like, I'm going to definitely watch this replay. Like, it's incredible how much he came back.
Oh, he actually goes Boots of Travel upgrade. But speaking of bad start, Weehaw hasn't really recovered that much. I mean, he has some items now, but we're talking 56 minutes in, 20 intelligence, which is virtually nothing for a carry, or a mid silencer, I should say.
I mean, silencer can't farm as fast, and he's easier to kill. It's hard to contribute as much. He gets initiated on by like battle cry into arrow every time, and he just doesn't have the survivability to make up for that. His team's lacking disables in some ways. They're very good at dueling and doing Sven damage, but they just need like a Ravage or something. They need some AoE disable to give them a couple seconds to do damage uncontested.
Ooh, Moonlight Shadow. Looks like EG actually wants to do something. Roshan is going to be up in 30 seconds.
Morphling dies.
Ooh, Burrow striked in. He's taking so much damage. Sonic Wave. Global Science is there. Soxa healing him up. Universe is forced out. BKB's popped galore. Everybody's a golden monkey these days. It looks like Stamail's going to be the target of choice for Legion Commander. Doesn't get his duel off in time. We've seen the Epicenter coming to the fray on three heroes into a Sonic Wave. The damage is out of control for EG, and this looks to be it. Legion Commander loses the duel. Arteezy takes 18 extra damage as if he needed it. PyCat trying for a last-ditch effort, but he gets kited to a high degree, and GG's come out. EG win 2-0 in this first group stage match. My god, what a game.
The Mama's Boys fight looked so good at the start, but they couldn't duel the Queen of Pain. She had a Lincoln, so he's standing there. He's like, god, I'd really like to duel you, but I know you have a Lincoln. This isn't going to do anything, and they had no way to stop those Lincolns when the BKB is also up. So if they would have dueled the Quap, they may